Very pleasant evening to you all. Hearty welcome to this webinar on carbon credits, a citizen's role. Let me introduce briefly as a professor of civil engineering with specialization in environment engineering. I did my B.Tech civil engineering and M.Tech environment engineering from SVNIT Surat, and then did PhD in air pollution control technology from JNT Hyderabad. This mobile I have given as Ihidia C-phase because one of the top challenges of the world today is that people have stopped thinking, because A is the first letter, B is the second letter, C is the third letter, D is fourth one, and E is fifth one, I is ninth letter. Ihidia C-phase, you please read it as 98491361135. Thank you very much for bearing with the new style of mobile, and let us go to the webinar. There are 42 slides, and the first one is let us go green. It is good as gold to go green. Here green means, the general meaning of the term green is that anybody who is environment friendly, animal friendly and energy efficient in his habits is generally regarded as green. There is another synonym of the term green, and that is intelligent. For example, we call them as green lips. Green lips are actually intelligent lips. So green buildings, we call them also as intelligent buildings or energy efficient buildings. So similarly, green means intelligent, green means environment friendly. So with this, let us go to the next point. Let me just briefly give in one slide the preamble of the webinar. The priorities of the world today are the four E's: energy, environment, economics and education. If engineering is socio-economic development of the system using the available resources, then carbon credits or international carbon credit satisfies all the four priorities of the society. CO2 in the ambient atmosphere today is about 387 ppm, while the safe value or sustainable value is 350 ppm. Green habits are activities of a citizen that are environmentally friendly by reducing the CO2 levels in the atmosphere from 387 ppm. If 1 ton of CO2 is removed because of a person's activity, like walking instead of using a motorbike, or using a bus instead of his own car or bike, he or she will get one carbon credit. In international market today, one carbon credit is 1 ton CO2 removed is equal to $10, which comes to about ₹600. This webinar discusses a citizen's role in international carbon trade and motivates the citizens to become environmentally friendly entrepreneurs. This webinar is let us learn something through questions and answers, mainly 5 questions. These are the 5 questions. We will go to that one by one. The outcome of this is that the student develops the holistic approach of applying engineering to benefit society at large. The student becomes proactive, and this will make him a responsible citizen. It improves their analytical ability, AA, and interpretation quotient, IQ, like anything. This out-of-box thinking makes learning fun and motivates a student to become an entrepreneur and a global engineer. Students will feel the pride and joy of becoming a global engineer. Student will realize the importance of green habits for a sustainable development and will try to develop green technologies for a better tomorrow. Let us go back, let us recollect some of the general meanings of the terms that are very frequently used with the basic meanings of certain words. Engineering means innovation, invention or creation. Engineering is problem solving ability. An engineer is the enabler of progress. Engineers are nation builders, said Jawaharlal Nehru. An engineer is the spine of the society, said your Murali Krishna. Engineering is socio-economic development using the available resources. Let us recollect that resource is anything of value is called resource. Now let us go to some of the synonyms of the terms business. The etymology of business is busylessness, that is work or profession, venture, adventure, trade, commercial enterprise or establishment. Now all this I am talking because our today's topic is carbon credits, and it is a very big international carbon trade, and carbon credits are both are same in fact. Some of the terms like synonyms of the term green are, there are some negative meanings also like sickly or under, inexperienced, overcome with envy. But the on positive note, the meaning synonyms of green are environmentalist, environmentally friendly, energy efficient and sustainable, full of life and vigor, fresh, new, recent. Synonyms of the term intelligent. If you refer any dictionary, Oxford dictionary, you will get these meanings. Most of us, whenever I say us, the students, you can take it as students. End of a class, if you consider yourself as a student, a learner, most welcome. Capacity of synonyms of intelligent or meanings of the term intelligent are, according to Oxford dictionary, intelligence means capacity of mind, ability to learn, ability to acquire knowledge, ability to understand and interpret, ability to apply knowledge to practice and real life. IQ stands for intelligence quotient, but since 2011 they have changed it, they call it as interpretation quotient. So intelligence means ability to, main point is ability to apply knowledge to practice in real life. To whatever we learn today, unless we put them into practice, at least to some extent, then we are not intelligent. Green concrete means fresh concrete. Green lift or intelligent lift, or green lift means intelligent lift or energy efficient lift. Here, the lift is programmed so that, suppose you are standing in the third floor and the lift is in the ground floor. Another lift is there in the seventh floor. Then if you press both the buttons, which lift should come to you so that the energy is, less energy is consumed. Like that, for different combinations of movement of energy, whenever a person is in first floor or second floor or third floor, during that time the lift is in seventh floor and first floor, or second floor and seventh floor, or third floor and fifth floor, like that, it is programmed so that the lift operation becomes energy efficient, less energy is consumed. That is also known as intelligent lift. Green TV, we call the term like Discovery Channel, History Channel, Animal Planet, that are mainly meant for environment awareness. Green buildings or intelligent buildings or energy efficient buildings that cause less damage to environment. Now green laws, Environment Protection Act was established in 1986, WALTA, Water and Land Use Act was established in 2002. As per this, borewell even for a house without permission is a crime. ENGO stands for Environment Non-Government Organizations. WWF stands for World Wildlife Fund for Nature. It was established in 1961. Green business means enterprises, international carbon trade. It is a green business only. That is why I am telling this about green business. Enterprises are establishments that are environmental friendly by being energy efficient after understanding and using sustainable and socially acceptable green technologies. Green mining, mining that is sustainable and environmental friendly. A green miner does not exploit the mine greedily. Green ethics. In Germany, wasting food is a crime. It is law. If you purchase with money, and if you waste, and if you argue that it is my money, then they say only one thing, you have to pay a fine of almost $10. many places it amounts to nearly $100. $100 means nearly 6,000 rupees you have to pay. And the only thing they say is money is yours, but resources are of society. For example, if you take a pizza or any food item, then money may be yours, but for the making of the food item, a distant in some place, some wheat is used. Somebody has grown wheat. His efforts were wasted, and all these resources directly or indirectly, and the material is transported to this place, and it generated a lot of pollution. It generated a lot of carbon dioxide. So, this is the aspect. Green habits. Greens means deep green, social green, shallow green. Shallow, deep greens means they are almost like extremists. If they feel that if somebody is cutting a tree intelligently, then he won't hesitate even taking the extreme step of even killing him or doing something like that. If he feels that somebody is very much harmful to animals or environment, then it is something like the religion. They take extreme steps and go to any extent to damage the persons responsible for such type of damage to the environment. Shallow greens means they are not that environment friendly, and we are all generally 99% of us, we all are all social greens. That means if there is any slightest possibility, we are environment friendly, but generally we do not give that much importance to that. I'm telling 99% of the people are like that. Now, these are all the terms we have seen already. Green technologies means energy efficient technologies, environment friendly technologies. I always start my program with green greetings. If you greening means greening the green politics, green business. For example, in Germany, Germany is ruled by Die Grünen, which is world's largest environment based party. That means all the major issues they fight, they are all environment based only. So that is why this is known as green politics. And Die Grünen is the largest political party, which is actually ruling Germany. And you are seeing Gro Harlem Brundtland, who is the person responsible for the sustainable development. Now, let us get back to our business main topic, and that is citizens' role and how to reduce the size of carbon footprint. If not you, who? If not now, when? 350 ppm concentration of carbon dioxide is the safe upper limit for CO2 in atmosphere. Today, we are at 387 ppm, that is 37 ppm higher than the safe or sustainable limit. Climate scientists now warn that if action is not taken soon with catastrophic climate change, humans will be on the brink of extinction. Let us not be in an illusion that it is not us, but our next generation which is in danger. The young are about to see the worst scenarios even before reaching their adulthood. The reason for major floods in Mumbai, Vijayawada, Kurnool is the climate change which is caused by global warming. According to IPCC, all Himalayan rivers like the Ganges will cause excess flooding, increasing MSL, submergence of rich and fertile lands and polluting groundwater sources as happening now, becomes seasonal like the South Indian rivers in its next phase, and then once the ice is lost, rivers become dry by 2035. This leads to food scarcity, poverty, depletion of resources, famine, violence, human values, the vicious circle swirls. Can you imagine the amount of social instability that we are going to see far before 2035? Do you feel the historic responsibility on today's youth? Let us recollect the words of Detweiler, who said, man will kill himself if he thoughtlessly and violently upsets the delicate web of life of which he is a part, not a part. Man will realize only when the last tree is felled that he can't eat money. Only when the last pond dries, he will realize he can't drink money. Sweet is the lore which nature brings. Man's meddling intellect misshapes the beauteous forms of things we murder to dissect. Caution, William Wordsworth. We ignored him, saying his words are worthless. As man is ascending the ladder of civilization rung by rung, his needs are increasing in mathematical progression, but the corresponding rise in pollutions and depletion of resources are in geometrical progression, forcing the disasters to devastate us in exponential progression. Is this the ascent of mankind? No, never. It is the descent of a decent man. Think green, at least now. Now, this is a beautiful advertisement by the Die Grünen political party, Green Party. Greens reduce carbon footprints in the carbon trade. That is what we have to interpret from this. Now, let us once again recollect, one carbon trade is equal to 1 ton CO2 removed is equal to $10 is equal to ₹600. Now, let us understand the basis of the carbon trade using this slide. Carbon plus O2 gives CO2. So, carbon is 12, O2 is 32, 2 into 16, 32, CO2 is 12 plus 32, 44. That means, if trees, what do? They absorb the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. As a result, they grow. That means their trunk, it increases. So, the trunk of a tree is the carbon. The carbon in the trunk of the tree is due to the absorption or taking up of CO2 from the atmosphere. That means if 44 kg of CO2 is removed from the atmosphere by a tree, its carbon value is 12. That means, or in other terms, if the weight of a trunk is 12 kg, then it means that 44 kg of CO2 is removed. Now, 1 ton of tree trunk is equal to 44 by 12, that is 3.67 tons of CO2 removed. Now, we know that 1 ton of CO2 removed is 1 carbon credit. Just like today, most of the semester systems, we get credits. Lab, we get 2 credits. Theory subject, we get 4 credits. Final year project work, we get 12 credits. Depending on the importance of that subject or course, we get certain credits. Similarly, how much you are reducing CO2 in the atmosphere, your activities, based on that you will get a credit. So, a tree gets a credit of 1 credit if it removes 1 ton of carbon dioxide. So, if the tree has a trunk of weight 1 ton, then it is due to 3.67 ton of CO2 removal from the atmosphere every year. Now, let us go to the first question. You will appreciate this very much. This is a very important question, and the question is, if a 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer wasteland is used for plantation at a spacing of 10 meter by 10 meter, find the annual revenue it generates. We all have several wastelands in our country. For example, even in Sri Lanka, Colombo Premdasa Cricket Stadium is there. It is actually, it is a wasteland. It is converted to a cricket stadium, and now people are getting a lot of income from that. So, conversion of wastelands to useful lands. So, similarly, our country has so many wastelands, and if we can convert that wasteland into plantation, let us see how revenue can be generated. Such type of plantation is called energy plantation. They may not give any fruits, they may not give any medicinal value also, but even a simple tree grows also, then that is sufficient because it absorbs carbon dioxide, and if carbon dioxide is there in the atmosphere, because of greenhouse effect, the temperature increases. Because temperature increases, mean sea level, ice caps, they melt, and because of flooding, the sea levels will increase, and it causes several other devastating problems. So, for all the problems of the world, today, the number one challenge of the world is climate change caused by CO2 in the atmosphere. So, the CO2 in the atmosphere must be decreased. Instead, we are actually doing, what we are doing is, we are increasing CO2. Now, let us come back to the question first. The answer is like this. If a 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer waste stand is developed by a community for energy plantation of 10 meters spacing, 100 saplings by 100 saplings, that is 10,000 plants, they will be planted. After 5 years, they yield wood at, assume that 1 ton each tree becomes after 5 years, 1 ton of trunk it develops. That means 10,000 plants you become 10,000 tons of carbon. Now we have already seen that 12 kg carbon is due to absorption of 44 ton, removal of 44 kg of CO2. So 10,000 tons of carbon in the trees means 10,000 into 44 by 12, that is 36,700 tons of CO2 is removed from the atmosphere by that simple area of 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer. So this comes to 36,700 carbon credits. So number of trees planted is 100 by 10,000, assume weight of trunk after 1 year or 5 years I have taken as a 1 ton. So the carbon credits you will get it as this much. $1 is 600 rupees. So revenue generated is 600 into 36,700, which comes to 2 crore 20 lakh only. Here, I'm sorry, a small mistake is there here, 20, okay. It is 2 crore 20 lakh only. Wasteland is given, here you will appreciate that, wasteland is given by, wasteland is given by the government and money is given by UN. Here, one should know or appreciate that if a person, if you are an entrepreneur and if you are getting lot of wealth, it is public money you are getting. But even though you are getting, it is national wealth only. So, whereas this is not like that. Here, the profit will be given by UN, UNO. So, your country, you are not getting the money of your own fellow countrymen. You are getting money from the entire world. It generates certain money as it pulls up certain money towards these global activities, and from those activities you are getting it. So you are getting the money of all the 223 countries, assuming there are 224 countries, all the 223 countries of the world, they will pay you this money through UNO. The beneficiaries of the such project are the underprivileged people. We all know a society can be judged by the manner in which it treats its underprivileged. This is international carbon trade. So you are getting money basically from all the countries of the world through UNO. So with such a case, a wasteland or mined area is converted for energy plantation with the tribal women and the socially and economically backward people as the main beneficiaries. Such activities can be initiated only by the government officials, executed by ENGOs, Reliance Energy Limited, Tata Motors, Indo Gulf Fertilizers, etc. are registered carbon credit traders. Now, let us go to the question number 2. What is the green habit? What are the possible green habits a citizen can develop? And what are the benefits to the global environment habit-wise? Think globally, work locally is the slogan of the day. Let us educate others about power saving. Energy saved is energy generated. In fact, 1 unit of electricity saved is 2 units of electricity produced. We all know that. Let every one of us practice the ways of reducing energy consumption and then preach others and be a part of the simplicity movement for sustainable development to cut energy consumption at houses and thus bring back CO2 to the safe limit of 350 ppm following or some of the sustainable lifestyles. Carbon credits of some of the green habits, let us see. One is, thinking is the hardest thing. That is why probably people stop thinking, said Henry Ford. You may not afford, but certainly you can afford to think. Think green. It is the rational thinking that makes an animal a man and a man divine. Choosing sun-dried cloths versus a dryer saves off a daily carbon diet of 2.3 kg of CO2. Now we have done a problem. If you know that instead of a dryer, if you are using open drying, sun-dried. It is not only good for health, if you are saving a lot of energy, and ultimately it directly or indirectly is responsible for reduction of CO2 by 2.3 kg of CO2 is gained. So once in a week, suppose you are doing like this, instead of a dryer, you are using a sun-dried cloth once in a week. Just imagine 50 weeks in a year, and then say 20 years of your life average. How many credits, how many tons of CO2 you will be doing it in a very short period of time? In Sanskrit they say, kshanashas kanashas chaiva vidyam ardham cha sadhe kshanonashto kruto vidya kanonashto kruto dharaha. By doing once in a life, every day if you do something good, every day it becomes a habit, then definitely you will bring a great difference in the entire world. Now let us go to another small question, that is question 1B. If an industry or institution with 200 employees develops the greatest green habit of planting one plant or employee per employee per year, what is the international carbon trade? The answer is like this. If an industry or institution, 200 employees goes for one plant per employee per year on the birthday of the industry or the institution, or on any one auspicious day, if every employee has to go, 200 employees is a very small industry. After 5 years, it would come to 1,000 trees. 1,000 plants become 1,000 trees at 1 ton each. Each tree will be weighing 1 ton. Trunk. That is 37,000 carbon credits. We have already seen 1 ton of carbon, 1 ton into 44 by 12. So 37,000 carbon credits you get because there are 200 employees. This comes to rupees 17.5 million per year. That means nearly 1.7 crore. So such projects can be developed by government or entrepreneurs or societies sponsored by government. Once again, revenue can be claimed from the UN. However, unless every one of us contribute our might, such mighty cherished goals cannot be fulfilled. Let us go to question number 3. If a person comes to college only on foot or on a bicycle instead of a motor bike, how much of CO2 will be reduced by him in a year? What is the revenue he can generate? This is as a simple citizen, environmentally conscious citizen, as a green, maybe as a social green only. If we can, we need not be a deep green, we need not fight against the damage that is being caused to the environment because of our careless activities. But as a simple human being, humble human being, responsible citizen, what is the thing that every one of us can do? Please solve this problem yourself. I'm giving the main hint here, and that is, taking a train or bus, that is a mass transportation system rather than the car, for a commute of as little as 8 kilometer will save a big 1.7 kg of CO2. That means if your office is at a distance of 8 kilometer, then or 4 kilometer, to and fro 8 kilometer, then instead of that you are using a mass transportation system, or you are using a carpool. Some four of you are going using only one car instead of one person using a single car because of that. Suppose a boss is there which is in a very high position, then generally they may not feel like sharing the car with others. But at least most of the, except one or two employees of an industry, all other persons, they can in fact share a car. They can travel by one car, four persons. This develops relationship also. A great person said, leadership is relationship. So a real leader, he always enjoys the relationship he has in that car while traveling together. So 8 kilometers, if you go for mass transportation system instead of a car, you are removing 1.7 kg of CO2 from the atmosphere. So in 1 year, how many tons you will remove, and in a over period of life, in a 20 years or 30 years, how much we all can together remove. And the fourth question is, what are the top 10 challenges in the world and how many of them can be solved by your carbon credits, our carbon credits? Engineering is problem solving ability, and the top 10 problems or challenges of the world are this. I have got it from the net, internet, and there will be several answers, and 90% of the, if you type in Google, top 10 challenges of the world, then 90% of the cases you will get these as the answer. The first challenge or problem of the world is poverty and food scarcity. The second one is global warming. The third one is ozone holes. The fourth one is waste, its treatment and disposal. Next is population. As a result, dwindling of resources like water. Another one is loss of biodiversity. Then another one is energy. Another one is health. Another one is human values. That is, already I have told that people have stopped thinking completely. Today, modern student, you ask him, he does not apply mind at all. Completely the thinking ability has gone. People, especially in our country, they crave for marks and they do not conduct any experiments properly. As a result, people have completely stopped thinking. The main reason is cell phone also is one culprit. We stopped reading books. If you stop reading books, then also you cannot think. So cell phone also, it keeps you very busy, you cannot think. So all these things have made man stop thinking. In fact, the only characteristic feature of a human being compared with other animals of the world, it is the ability to think. We all think, we think. And the solutions to all the above problems are education, education and education. Tony Blair, when he was the British Prime Minister, he said, for all the problems of the world, there are only three solutions, and that is education, education and education. And it is 100% true that education is the solution to all problems of the world. It only can solve. Teaching is the only profession that teaches all other professions, and education is the only solution to all the problems of the world. And we have to bring a lot of awareness to the world. For example, it is believed that these studies, the psychology based studies, they say that 12 years to 11 years to 14 years. In this age group, that is, let us say 6th class to 9th class, in this age group, in those children, if we can educate them and inspire them about these environment-friendly activities and green habits, it will bring a lot of change in the entire world. These children, they take the points so beautifully, so seriously, that they will force their parents and friends also to go for green habits. That is, if you tell him, if you can convince him that with a good point, if you can convince him that, see, you should not use polythene bags for milk packets, for carrying carry bags you should avoid. Then definitely we'll do a lot of good and great service to the world. Now, how this awareness can be created? And let us all appreciate Patnaik, who is known for making his great sculptures in sea sand. And most of his works are about creating awareness about global issues. And most of the works are about environment-related issues. This is a work he made in a sea sand about global warming caused by CO2. So he has not done any engineering. He is not a science graduate. He is a simple citizen with some responsible citizen of the world. He today is realizing that global warming is the greatest challenge and it is caused by CO2, and to create that awareness in the general public also, so that the general public also can bring a lot of change in them. We as engineers or scientists need to give a serious thought about this and implementing them in life. This is another beautiful presentation he made using sea sand. He has written, "Your carbon footprints have leather shoes." So you have to interpret like this, that see, if CO2 levels are increasing, they are increasing, and if they are not decreased, CO2 levels are high, then ice caps and glaciers will melt down, and if ice caps and glaciers will melt down, they will increase the sea level. That is a different thing, next effect. But immediate effect is all the polar bears, they will face extinction. So this leads to a lot of biodiversity, loss of biodiversity. So this awareness is created by Northeast, and how much of a proactive approach we all should have as engineers, as scientists. So great men leave footprints for others to follow. They do not leave carbon footprints. Man is the pest of the planet. I have developed A to Z, some 26 points on how to go green, how to develop some of the green habits. I will very quickly go through them because time is short. We have another 15 minutes only to conclude this, so let me go quickly. I hope you are all fine with me, my voice and my presentation. I profusely thank every one of you for your great listening, and special thanks to all those who are listening to me for the second time, and super thanks to all those who are listening to me for the third time, because this is my third webinar, and I thank IUCE for giving me this great opportunity. Let us see these 26 lifestyles. Very quickly we'll go. Adopt a green way of life, think green, plan green, act green through 7 R's. Retire or refrain, that is refuse or reject, reduce, recover, repair, reuse, recycle and rethink. Avoid exploitation of resources. Avoid overfeeding, overbreeding, overplowing, overgrazing and overfelling of trees. The B, buy a fuel efficient car or vehicle. Drive less and make lesser trips. Use telecommunications, telephone, fax or telex instead of going places in person. Video conferences reduce a lot of travels and corresponding pollution. C, the three priorities of the world are energy, environment and education, achieved through green power, green cover and green technology. D, use lesser water sources of light. Replace regular light bulbs with CFLs, LEDs. Similarly, a 15 watt compact fluorescent bulb gives as much light as 60 watt incandescent bulb and lasts about 10 times higher. So how much of energy efficient you become and how much of CO2 you can remove from the atmosphere because of these green habits. E, educate. Careful use of large electric or gas appliances such as stoves, refrigerators, washing machines and dryers can save a lot of energy. Cloths should be washed in normal water rather than hot water. Sun-dried cloths are more present wear and require no artificial energy for drying. Bake several things at once rather than reheating repeatedly. Using less hot water for bathing, lowering the thermostat of the water heater and wrapping around it with an insulated blanket would reduce energy consumption significantly. Keeping the refrigerator's door closed, regular defrosting to reduce the ice buildup that prevents the heat exchange system from working well also would reduce energy. Air conditioners and refrigerators with better condensers and heat exchangers save 25 to 50% of power costs. Conduct environmental awareness programs, especially in schools. Children are the best group to target as they are next to God, and take things very seriously with lot of respect and reverence. F, keep an eye on energy use habits. Turn off lights, TVs, geysers, computers, etc. were not in use. If the first, if you are the first to switch off fans and lights after the class or seminar is over, we all know by now 1 unit electricity saved is equal to 2 units of electricity produced. Here some wordings are missing, missing, I will vex you. G, greatest green habit, plant trees, use both sides of paper, old calendars for rough work, greeting cards as visiting cards, encourage recycled paper. Remember 20 huge trees or 250 eucalyptus trees or 500 bamboo plants will be cut to produce 1 ton of paper. Salvage, store and sell gas, metals and papers and compost organic waste. Practice vermin composting for kitchen waste. Encourage organic farming. The market value of 1 kg of earthworms is about 1000 rupees. Take shorter cooler showers. Install water saving faucets and shower heads. Stop faucet leaks, especially hot water. Here I have to tell one more point, and that is many people have a habit of taking bath, bathing with using very, very hot water. But this is very bad and dangerous to health. Not only that, if you use warm water, it is good for health and you are consuming a lot of less amount of energy and you are more energy efficient and intelligent. So if you have the habit of taking bath with very, very hot water, immediately switch over to enjoy bathing using warm water only, never very hot water, which is very dangerous to your skin. H, take I, anything of value is called resource, example mines, water, biodiversity, mangroves. Use resources wisely for your need, not for greed. Where you could walk, walk, or at the most use a bicycle, even though it is easier to be carried than to walk. Use public transportation instead of using a private vehicle. Join a carpool if possible, drive a smaller, more efficient vehicle at reduced speed. Use steps instead of elevators. Extra sweater or blankets damage less than room heat. During summer days while using ACs and winter nights, close the windows and drapes. Use scented plants like night queen or day queen or both to save lots of deodorants and sprays. Tulsi and neem are excellent mosquito repellents. Coal power and other traditional power sources are highly carbon emitting. Think of alternatives such as wind, solar and hydroelectric and other renewable energy sources. Renewable energy is damaged less than coal and oil. If possible, use and encourage non-conventional energy sources such as solar heaters, solar cookers, windmills, etc. Eating lower on food chain reduces environmental damage. Grain-based diets are more resources efficient, efficient also than carnivory. Our muscles and teeth and our very long digestion tract are designed by God for vegetarian food only. If you are 35 plus, reduce intake as much as you can. 1 meal a day is more than sufficient. Of course, you may take a few fruits in the evening after 6. Prevention of pollutants and waste damage is less than their treatment. Reducing waste generation is number one green habit. Eat as much as, don't get surprised when I say so many things as number one green habits. All are equally important, so that made me talk like that. Eat as much as you can, but don't waste a grain. Every day, 7,000 Indian children of age less than 5 years, they die. Majority of them due to lack of sufficient food. D is missing here, I may be excused. Buy locally made long-lasting materials rather than momentary fads and lifestyles. For example, do not buy plastic chairs and other plastic items. Eat locally grown food mostly. Durability costs less than obsolescence. Polythene takes 200 to 600 years to disintegrate. Try to avoid them and carry your own cloth bag when you go to market. Don't choose disposable and use and throw products, except medical products. Join any good environmental group and start writing to elected representatives, newspapers, etc. and involve in some social service works regularly and frequently. Keep writing to magazines, newspapers and officials concerned about the problems you are facing. Join carbon credit clubs now. There are so many carbon credit clubs where they write as 350 carbon credit club, something like that. 350 is prominently written on the carbon credit club. There are so many carbon credit clubs in the world. So student clubs, you also start a student club Why they write 350 is 350 ppm of CO2 is the safe limit or sustainable value of CO2 in the atmosphere, whereas it is 387 in today's atmosphere. So we need to decrease it. Conduct quizzes or seminars about environmental awareness in local schools, clubs and firms. The best way to implement any social and global aspect is to educate children of age 10 to 15. Repeatedly I am telling this, and let me take pride in telling you all that I have actually A to Z, I have written some of the points. All these points which I am showing you, I brought out in the form of a two pages on either side of two pages. I published or printed about 25,000 copies so far, and I have distributed to all school children and industrialists, etc., etc. The only hope is that even 0.1% of these people also, if they sincerely, religiously, they get convinced by that, treating environment as our common religion and treating environment as God, divine, then if we can change and bring some change in our lifestyles, bring these sustainable lifestyles into our life, my effort definitely will be of a great help. So, on similar works, you also can do it. I can mail all this information, which is available in the form of a compact form, the soft copy I can mail, so that you also can circulate among the students of your areas. Teach your children and friends about the environment and what they should do to become eco-friendly citizens. Be away from fallacies and superstitions. Treat nature as the physical form of God and love all his components, that is animals, creatures and trees. Have a strong sense of love, respect and reverence towards nature. While purchasing any object, care to know the eco-score of alternatives based on the resources and energy consumed in producing the object, the pollution released during the production and recycling of biodegradation potential after the useful life of the object is over. Insecticides, cosmetics, tonics, medicines without competent prescription, instant foods, paints, varnishes, painted and colored articles, substandard gadgets and appliances, sharp toys, pesticide sprayed vegetables and fruits, detergents with strong chemical activity and several ill-designed household utilities can cause accidents and a slow poisoning of our body tissues. Consumer awareness on these aspects can save our micro-environment from sickening pollutants and hazards. Environment education solves such problems. Environmental self-audit. Celebrate World Environment Day every day. The need to conserve natural resources and protect the environment against pollutions and other man-made degradations is voiced unanimously all over the world. While one can say a lot about who should do what, little attention is given to what can do to himself to ensure better environment. A conscious environmental self-audit can help individuals to incorporate eco-friendly lifestyles in themselves, which alone can ensure a stable and long-range solution to ecological crisis. Apprehended today, an environmental self-audit submitted to one's own environmental concerns, if any, will go a long way in mitigating the ecological stresses of the day and the near future. The possible gains in physical and mental health through such self-appraisal could be the personal byproduct advantage. Self-evaluation of eco-grading may follow a questionnaire designed by one's own knowledge and conscience. Have a vision and keep revising your vision. That means every one of us, we should think now and then, compared with last year, what are the environment friendly activities I am doing this year. Compared with last month, what are the good things I have done in this month. Something like that. Every year there must be a change in us with reference to our concern towards environment. As we are aging, our wisdom should grow and we should start thinking and try to implement all these environment friendly activities into real life, and that is intelligence. Green habits, green attitude, green buildings, green chemistry, green designs, green engineering, green fashions, green readings, green ambitions, green business, green politics and green wishes, green dreams of zero emissions. Waking up with a traditional wind up alarm rather than beep of an electric one saves about 50 grams of CO2 every day. So it is not even kg, 50 grams only, but it makes a difference. because every day we use 2-3 times alarm. Replacing a 45 minute workout on a treadmill by jogging in a nearby park saves nearly 1 kg of CO2. Just see, 45 minutes if you go and spend time with nature, how much of pleasure and psychological and spiritual pleasures you get, you derive when you move with nature. It is as though you are playing on the lap of your mother as a child when you visit nature, when you are in the nature. Instead of that, if you are spending that 45 minute jogging also on a treadmill with the technology, how unfortunate we are in our life. Live as close as possible to nature. That is, if you jog instead of using the power driven treadmill, you will get 0.3650 carbon credits. As you are responsible for reduction of 365 kg CO, you will get about ₹225 per year, which may be a small money, but a great ecological benefit. See, ₹225 per year may be very less for you. Today, most of us, we have everything with us, but we have nothing with us. What I want to say is, we have everything with us. As per the modern living, people think that money is everything, our status is everything, power is everything. So all these we are having, but the real beauty of life, the real happiness, all these are missing. So ₹225 per year may be very less for you, for every one of us. Today everybody is having money, lot of money, but how much of self-satisfaction we derive thinking that I have done a small thing and I have not charged that ₹225 also, I have not taken from the UNO. I am just doing it as a responsible citizen, I am doing it. With such type of great attitude if you are doing, you are leaving a great ecological footprint into the world. Heating bread rolls in a toaster versus an oven for 15 minutes saves nearly 170 gram of CO2. Switching from regular 60 watt bulb to energy saving ones will produce 4 times less greenhouse gas emissions. Shutting down your computer both during lunch break and working hours will cut CO2 generated by them by 1/3. Investing in a water saving shower head will not only save 10 liters of water per minute, but will also slash CO2 emissions resulting from a 3 minute hot shower by half. Insist on solar cooking system instead of liquid gas burner and obtain tastier and healthy food. Ecological footprints. We have seen it. So great men do good and leave footprints for others to follow. Naturalists reduce carbon footprints for generations to live. Let environment be our common religion and let nature rule our minds. Think, my dear friend, think. For God sleeps in the rock, wakes and dresses in the planet, walks and wanders in the animal, but thinks and does in the man. Let our present thinking be guided by a promising future. Telling people you will reduce carbon emissions may seem simplistic, but even simple actions like announcing your commitment to going carbon neutral can be effective, while the simple act of asking for ideas can lead to creative and innovative solutions. Several countries have indicated in recent years that they will go carbon neutral. What I want to tell you mainly is that today, when you bring a lot of awareness, there will be one or two students definitely who will be so much inspired by your words and actions that they will do a lot of good works to the world. And if they become great, taking you as an inspiration also, then your life's dream is fulfilled. So, little drops of water make the mighty ocean, little grains of sand the present land. Every one of us can contribute something in this angle. Why I have given is, this is not the last slide, my email ID I have given, because this is how I have ended that pamphlet which I published, which I printed, got printed 25,000 copies. Now let us come to the concluding part of this. Vyardhat ardham yameva prajna. Vyardha means waste. Vyardhat means from waste. Ardham means wealth. Vyardhat ardham yameva prajna. Wealth from waste is engineering. Money from chimney is engineering. Dollar from dung is engineering. See, here we have seen that there is a wasteland and it is now converted to a mini forest like. It decreases the temperature of that area very much. So because of climate change, we all know temperatures are shooting up like anything. So the temperature will reduce enormously. Not only that, a wasteland is converted to a forest land and it has reduced the CO2 value significantly. All this is wealth from waste only. So wasteland is converted into carbon credits, money. Money from chimney is engineering, dollar from dung is engineering, science from awareness is engineering, knowledge from everything is engineering, enlightenment from entertainment is engineering. The Odyssey from now, this webinar, is success. Good to nature, our God, is noble green business to the noble. Actually, book to nature is a beautiful aspect told by Rousseau. Rousseau influenced Leo Tolstoy and several persons very much, and all his works are connected. In simple term, it is called book to nature. So his book is Social Contracts. It is very famous, in which he writes very beautifully. This is not directly related to that. Let me just skip it. And the last bottom slide is Yardhat Ardham. Idameva Karma Kausalam. Karma Kausalam means skill. Now, the slogan of engineering students or engineering or MCA or MBA is Yogaha Karmasu Kausalam. Whatever you are doing, do it skillfully. Then you are a yogi. That is what Yogaha Karmasu Kausalam. Karma means job. Kausalam means skill. Whatever you are doing, do it sincerely. Tapaha Swadharma Vartitvam. According to Mahabharata, tap is that swa means self. Dharma means your job or your whatever you do. Vartitvam, vartitvam means you do it. Whatever you do, do with lot of sraddha, bhakti, respect and reverence, completely involved in that, then that is tap. That is tapaha, tapaha swadharma vartitvam. So karma kausalam means skill. Engineering is skill. Idam eva, idam means this. Eva means only. Just like satyam eva deyate, satyam alone wins. Idam eva. Means this alone is karma kausalam. So vyardhat ardham idameva karma kausalam. This is skill. Vyardhat ardham idameva karya kausalam. Karya kausalam means management. So what is management? Vyardhat ardham, that is management. Vyardhat ardham idameva sanketika shastram. Sanketika shastram means engineering. Vyardhat ardham idameva jnanam. This is knowledge. But in Sanskrit, there is a principle, and that is yardhat ardham iyameva prajna. That is how we should write. Because iyam, prajna is a feminine gender. Whereas all other things like skill, management, engineering, knowledge, they are all masculine genders. Prajna is application of skill, management, engineering and knowledge in life. So it is the mother of all qualities. That is why it is a feminine gender, because it is mother of all qualities. We have to write iyam. Iyam means this, eva prajna. So, but prajna is application of, you have engineering, you have management skills, you have knowledge. All that is a waste. Only when you apply them to real life, put it into practice, then only the society can prosper, then only you are the enabler of progress, you are an engineer. Prajna is application of knowledge or skill and is the mother of all qualities. So the last slide says, Green Nobel laureates of 21st century, when you recollect, Wangari Maathai, she did only one thing, and that is, she planted saplings. It is planting a tree or sapling is a very, very small job. But that small job only, she did it for nearly 30 years, that too with lot of interest and respect, and changing the rules of the Swedish Nobel committee, they gave that global peace or world peace is possible only because of environmental protection. So they have given Wangari Maathai, changing the rules, Nobel Prize for her green color. R.K. Pachauri got Nobel Prize for green power, that is energy. Al Gore, because of green education, that is bringing awareness about environmental aspect, he brought out a beautiful film called An Inconvenient Truth about everything is made of carbon credits and climate change and global warming, all caused by CO2. So my wish is that the next person should be from those who listen, who have participated in this webinar. And if you can do such type of green business, environment friendly business, or which is something like carbon credits, then definitely this program is a grand, grand success. Thank you all very much for your great, great listening. Yours in nature, KVSP Murali Krishna. Thank you very much. Hello?
Yes, sir, thank you, sir. Hello? We will give them 1 or 2 minutes if, in case there are any questions.
Okay.
Yes, sir. So, don't see any questions. Thank you very much for the webinar, sir.
Thank you very much, Sridhar. I think it was a quite a useful webinar and everything went nicely.